Hello everyone and happy World Book Day. I hope you've been enjoying reading lots of different stories over today. Today I'm going to read you this story, The Invisible by Tom Percival. Oh, you can just see his name there. And this is a brand new book. It came out at the start of February, so I'm very lucky to get my hands on it. So I hope you enjoy it and I will give you an activity to do at the end of it, which you can upload to Showbie to show your teachers that you've listened to this story. Hope you like it.
The Invisible by Tom Percival. Isabel pulled on her favourite jumper, eyes curled across the inside of the window, and crept up the corner of her bedpost. It was very beautiful, and Isabel always noticed beautiful things, but there was no escaping the fact that it was also cold, very cold. You see, Isabel's family couldn't afford to have the heating on. Isabel's family couldn't afford a lot of things, things that some people take for granted. But Isabel tried not to worry about the things she didn't have. After all, she and her family had everything that they needed. They had each other. But one day, there just wasn't enough money to pay the rent and all the bills. Isabel and her family had to leave their home, the house which held all their happy memories, and move to the far side of the city. For the first time ever, Isabel couldn't find anything beautiful to cheer herself up. This part of the city looked exactly how she felt, cold, sad, and lonely. A family drove past in a shiny car, but they looked straight through Isabel, as though she wasn't even there. None of the other smartly dressed people seemed to see her either. Isabel looked down and realised that she could barely see her own hands or her feet. She was fading away. Before long, Isabel was completely invisible. She drifted silently down the streets, as pale and thin as the wind, and nobody saw her at all. But now that Isabel was invisible, she noticed something she hadn't seen before. Other invisible people, lots of them. There was an old lady planting flowers in empty paint pots. There was the man who slept on a bench feeding the birds in the park. And there was the boy who had been forced to leave his home in another country helping to mend someone's bike. But they all seemed so alone. Isabel decided to help. She planted flowers in the paint pots. She looked after stray animals. And she helped to fix things up. Then, day by day and week by week, other people joined in too. And the more people came together, the more they could all be seen. Soon, Isabel wasn't just visible, she was vibrant, and so was her new home. And that was how Isabel made something very special, one of the hardest things that anyone can ever make. Isabel had made a difference.
So I hope you enjoyed that story. The activity that I'd like you to do on Showbie, if you remember the last page where it had all of that lovely, it was bright, it was vibrant, there were lots of people doing lots of different things. And what I'd like you to do is think about how you could make a difference. So draw a picture of your local area, of your street, and see if what you would include. Would you have somebody making hot dogs on the corner? Would you have people painting and so on? So draw me a picture, show me what your street would look like if everyone could make a difference. See you later.